This is our second video on IUPAC nomenclature, and we're going to introduce priority groups, specifically alcohols and amines in this video. So any previous discussion on alkanes and alkyl halides and that sort of thing without priority groups can be seen in the first IUPAC nomenclature video. Okay, so we're going to look today at single priority groups. Okay, and we're not going to consider mixed priority groups, so more than one type of priority group in the same molecule. And we're not going to consider stereochemistry just yet. So that's coming. But today, this is what happens if we have an alcohol or an amine individually in a molecule. And so anytime we start a nomenclature video, we're always going to look at our roadmap, because that's what we always have to do in a naming problem. We've got to circle the parent chain. We've got to label the names of groups intersecting that circle. And we've got to number the chain so that we are ready at the very end to put the name together. We've got all the tools we need laid out in the most logical way that I can think of to do it. Okay, so let's look at additional factors to consider for each of these rules when dealing with a single priority group. So picking the parent chain is where the first difference comes up. We don't pick just the longest carbon chain. We have to also contain the priority group. So if we can make a longer carbon chain, that doesn't necessarily matter. We've got to pick the longest chain that also contains the group. So no matter what I do for this first example, my parent chain has to start with the priority group already contained. And then I pick the longest branch at that point to continue with the parent chain. So I get more carbons this way than I would going down the other way. Likewise, I must contain as many priority groups as I possibly can. So even though I can get a longer carbon-to-carbon chain going straight down the molecule, I have to pick the chain that contains both of the priority groups. Okay, I cannot continue down this way because there's no priority group down that way, and there is on each of the other two branches. So I pick a shorter chain in order to get both priority groups in. And then any tiebreakers with what's the priority group goes by the alkane tiebreakers, starting with number of groups, most branches wins, and then lowering the numbers, and then alphabetical order, and so forth. So that's the old video. Naming the groups, intersecting the circle. So there's not much difference here for any other group, but when we circle the parent chain, instead of giving a group name like methyl or methyl here with the amines and alcohols, they get a suffix in the parent chain name. Okay, so their priority group, they get named in a little bit of a different way. So we actually are going to put an ol as a suffix at the end of the name, or we're going to put the suffix amine at the end. So we're going to put a dash and just mark that so we remember to do it later. And other groups, like we said, are named as normal. Now, numbering the chain, the lowest number must go to the priority group. Okay, so this has got to happen, and the tiebreakers after that will follow alkene. So with this example, no matter which way I number, I'm going to put a 3 on that alcohol there. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 again, no matter which way. So now I revert to my old tiebreakers. I know where the parent chain is. Name the parent chain, or name the groups intersecting the circle. There's my old. And since I get a 3 either way, the next tiebreaker is a number. Well, I can put a 2 on each of these, numbering either way. So then I revert to alphabet. So there's a little bit of review for us. Chloro before methyl from last time. We'll look at more where we have to number the priority group lowest later, but there's a look back at our tiebreakers for alkanes. All right, so putting the name together, we're going to follow all the alkane rules, except the priority group will not need a number on a ring, okay, because it automatically gets the number 1. And then when we put the name together, there's two conventions we can use. And so rather than listing out all the specific rules, let's just try to do some examples to get these rules on paper. So we've already done this part for the previous two examples. We've circled the parent chain. We've labeled, and I'll use the abbreviation here for methyl, ol, amine. We've numbered the parent chain, putting the lowest number on the priority group possible. Okay, and so numbering from the right side does that. And so when we put the name together for these, two conventions. The first convention, we'll start with the alcohol. Alphabetical order for the groups, there's only one group that's not a priority group, so 4-methyl. And then we can either tag a number for the priority group. So the priority group's at the 2 position, pentane, drop the E, add the ol. Okay, so what did we do? We tagged a number before the parent name, and then we dropped the E and added a suffix. Okay, and so the other way we can do it is we can say 4-methyl and put the parent prefix first, pentane, 2-ol. Okay, so 4-methyl, pentane, 2-ol. We split and put down the middle. So for the split convention, you split before the prefix and then place the number tag where we split for the prefix. So that's the other way to do it. Both are correct. Okay, both work. So either way you choose to do it, either one will work for producing the name. And so then we do the amine as well. Here we have a 4-methyl 2-pentan prefix time amine, 4-methyl pentan 2-amine. So either way works. The rules are the same for putting together both priority groups, just the suffix changes. Okay, so the last thing we need to look at for both priority groups, alcohols and amines, are what if there's more than one in the same name. So we have to use our prefixes again, di, tri, tetra, and so forth for 2, 3, 4, and so forth. Well, we circle the parent chain as normal. We number, giving the lowest number to a priority group. So either way we number for these, we get the same numbers, so we can number either way. Okay, 1 to 5 there. And so we need the E at the end of the parent name, and here's why. So we put it together, no other groups besides the suffix groups, so we say pentane, 1,5 pentan. Instead of saying pentandiol, which is hard to say, we say pentane diol. So we need the E at the end of the parent name for diols. We just split the prefix, put the E back in, or split the suffix off, put the E back in, and then add the prefix pentane diol. And so we can use the split convention, pentane, don't forget the E, 1,5 diol. For here, for the amine, we have a 1,5 pentane di amine, or we have a pentane 1,5 di amine. Okay, so either way, but we have to use the E when there's more than one, di, tri, tetra, and so forth. If we have a secondary and tertiary amine, so here we have an amine with 3 groups. It is a tertiary amine. It's got 2 methyls and then one connected to the parent chain. Anytime we have a secondary and tertiary amine, we're going to have a group attached to the nitrogen that's not part of the parent chain. So if we circle the parent chain, longest carbon chain that the amine is attached to, and we label our groups, we have to label the groups attached to the amine as well. And instead of tagging those with a number, we're going to tag those with a capital N, and we're going to treat them like a number, except we're going to list the N first. So it's better just to finish out the example and see how that looks. We number, putting the lowest number on the priority group, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we have, for the final name here, we have an NN3, so 3 methyls, trimethyl, 2 attached to nitrogen, the N's come first, then the numbers, NN3, trimethyl, butan, or we can do both conventions, 2-butanamine, or we can say N 3 trimethyl butan 2 amine. Either way is correct. And so we tagged the tertiary nitrogen, the two extra groups, with an N apiece to locate them. So let's work a few more full examples just to get the hang of this and make sure we are completely on board. So no question about the parent chain here. It's not up for debate. What's up for debate here? Once we name the groups, number two. What's tricky is which way do we number? Well, we know the priority group has to get the lower number. So even though bromo is before alcohol or before any way to say that group name, we get a lower number on the alcohol. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we're ready to put it together. Okay, and I'll just use one convention or the other at this point for time purposes here. And we've got a 5-bromo, 2-hexanol. 5-bromo, 2-hexanol. Or 5-bromo-hexan-2-ol. And here, we have to get both priority groups into the parent chain. So we have to go this way. And so that leaves us with a complex group. Okay, where we know the one position is here, 1, 2, 3, and then that complex group has a bromo. So if we put that group name together in parentheses, this is a 2-bromo propyl group, 2-bromo-propyl. 3 carbons long, bromo at the 2 position, 2-bromo-propyl group, and it cannot be named by any other method. And then we have 2 alcohols. So if we put the number on these for our rule number 3, so we've circled the chain number 1, wrote the name of the groups, number 2, and then now we want to number the chain. Turns out it's symmetrical, so it doesn't matter which way we number from, we get the same name, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when we put this name together, we have a 3 parentheses 2 bromopropyl, 3 2 bromopropyl, and let's use the split convention this time. We have a pentane, tag the numbers 2,4-diol. Okay, so 3,2-bromopropyl pentane 2,4-diol. Have to have the E in there when it's a poly-ol or a poly-amine. Okay, so a couple of amines now. Circle the parent chain. Again, lowest number, or we have to name the groups first, bromo ending amine number, putting the lowest number on the priority group. We have a 3-bromo and 3-bromo-1-propan amine. Don't need the E because it's only one amine. 3-bromo-1-propanamine. Now we have a cyclic here, so the largest chain containing the priority group. Okay, so 2 carbons is an alkyl chain that's attached to the amine, but we have a larger ring, 5, that's attached to the amine, and so therefore the 5-membered ring is the parent. Then we name our groups. We have an ethyl here. And attached to the secondary amine, we have another ethyl. So now we want to put the lowest number when we number here on the parent chain. Then we want the lowest number on the next group. So we number clockwise here, 4, 5. When we put the name together, we have to tag one of the ethyls with an N. So this is an N3-diethyl, okay, 2 carbon groups. N3-diethyl, and let's use the split convention here. We've got a cyclo for ring, cyclopentanamine. No one is needed, So it doesn't matter if we're using split convention or not. The one is not needed because we automatically get a one for the parent amine anyway. Okay, so it's an automatic one, so it does not need the one tag in the parent name. So N3-diethyl cyclopentanamine.